I'm Megan O'Levy, and this is your UFC Minute. This weekend, we brace for a crucial matchup, which is expected to shake up an entire division. To get into position for a world title shot, this fighter has fought tooth and nail against the best the heavyweight division has to offer. And while getting into a number one contender's match is sweet enough, if this fighter beats his heated rival to earn that shot at the belt, the victory would be even more satisfying. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
All right, coming up next, it's a heavyweight collision between the Pitbull Andre Arlovsky and Curtis Razor Blaydes. All right, so here he is, folks. The wait is nearly over for this one. Unquestionably a rivalry fight. These guys have really stolen the show during fight week, jawing at each other at the weigh-in. No love lost between these two fighters. Only one man can have his hand raised here tonight. Let's see who can bottle the emotions and produce here on the world's biggest stage.
This guy has one of the best abilities to take a shot that I have ever seen in all my years of commentating on fights. His chin is truly world class.
Well, he was a UFC champion more than a decade ago, more than 40 pro fights to his credit, and Andre Arlovsky on his night can still send the best heavyweights in the world twitching to the canvas. He's got some of the best takedown defense in the history of the division, and of course that allows him to get his hands on you and get the power game going. Training out of Jackson Wink MMA under the watchful eyes of Greg Jackson, Mike Winklejohn, Brandon Gibson. This is a plus athlete who is still getting it done in the big show, Joe.
He's very athletic, has a ton of natural quickness. You can see it in the way he moves around the octagon. He's got fast feet and a lightning quick jab. He's a very difficult guy to counterfight. As soon as you see the shot coming, he's tagged you.
And now our tail of the tape for this heavyweight fight. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age, with the same height and some differences in reach. All right, to get us started with the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record of 14 wins, 3 losses. He stands 64 inches tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. Fighting out of Chicago, Illinois, Curtis Razor. And now introducing his opponent, fighting corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 35 wins, 21 losses, and one no contest. He stands 64 inches tall, weighing in at 240 pounds. Fighting out of Chicago, Illinois, ladies and gentlemen, he is the former UFC heavyweight champion, Andre the Pitbull Arlovsky. And then the action begins.
So Mario Yamasaki, the veteran, draws the opening assignment here. We are ready to go with round one here. All right, so here we go with round one as we get this rivalry matchup underway. These fighters, of course, do not like each other. They have said they will try to just focus on their skills and letting their skills take over. Easier said than done, of course, when you're sharing the octagon with someone who you have such legitimate disdain for. Oh, big roundhouse attempt, but unable to land.
Oh, he caught him in the left.
He's got him here. Trying to establish that jab once again. Well, he's doing a nice job keeping the guard up, but that usually means the body is wide open, and his opponent wisely saw that and landed the straight hand to the body. Let's see if he shores some things up here defensively to prevent that fake move.
Oh! He's definitely blocked. Oh! Big shot!
So here we go. Round one is underway of this rivalry fight here tonight. Perhaps there will be a little bit of a feeling out process here. Both guys were trying to put the emotions out of the equation here tonight. But it is rival versus rival under the lights here tonight.
Yeah, he's digging into that leg.
Edge of your seat action as expected so far. All right, the first round is underway here. You've got to watch out for this fighter's powerful overhand punches can do damage from both sides. And even when fighters know what's coming, oftentimes they are unable to stop.
Good defense there.
He's doing a great job timing these shots.
Oh, big elbow. And now he lands a combination.
Takedown.
Oh, head kick, Joe. Left hand, though, up to block. Nicely done.
Good right hand on the top. He's hurt.
Oh!
Oh, he got clipped there. He got hurt.
He takes. The kick lands, and he's down. That's it. He's out.
Wow.
Tremendous hook. Landed flush for the victory.
Yeah, man, crowd loving it. Just a gorgeous shot there to end the fight. Really just the way he drew it up. He found the opening and capitalized on it to the utmost extent. Nicely done to finish the fight.
Let's take a look at it from another angle here. This is the one that causes the knockdown and the subsequent follow-up strikes for the knockout. Look at this. I mean, just stiff.
So there he is after a monument. Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 36 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Carson Wendell.
All right, so the celebration is on in the corner, and he has certainly earned it after coming through and coming up large in this rivalry fight here tonight. He wanted this one in the worst way, and man, did he seize the spotlight here in this one.